Hey YouTube, it's Bill again from Southern California. Haven't uploaded a haul video in a while. Been busy basically just selling my inventory I have, but went out yesterday for a couple hours and found some really good stuff. So let's go ahead and start out with the clothes. Found some clothes and a couple of vintage mid-century pieces that are should do well. So anyway, so here's a work shirt, Carhartt, XL, should sell well. This was $4. Should be able to get around 25 for it. Here's a Orvis. This is the Fairbanks shirt, and this one has the suede patches on the elbows here. Really nice condition. Should be able to get 30 for this one. Then we have a Pendleton. It's size XL. It's in nice condition. Should be able to get 40 for this one. And it's made in the US. And also picked up some Tommy Bahama shirts. This one is a half zip, long sleeve. It's got the embroidered Marlin on it. And this was $4, and should be able to get 30 for it. My Goodwill was having a sale on shirts. All of them were $4, so that was a good deal. And here's another one. This is a long sleeve t-shirt, size extra large. And on the back, it's pretty cool. It says Tommy Bahama, 12 Days of Christmas. And it's got various beer taps on it. Here's another one, size XL. This one's pretty cool. It's got rum on it. Some results it has right here. Has Habana, some cigars. That's pretty cool. Looking to get probably 30 for this one. There's a silk, size 2XL, 70% silk, 20% cotton. It's like a polo shirt. Should be able to get probably 25 for this one. And here we have a size large Ralph Lauren polo. It's got the red large pony on it. Then on the sleeve here, it's got a patch number 3. And should be able to get probably 35 on this one. Here's a Nat Nast. This one is 70% silk, 30% cotton. It's got kind of a texture to the shirt, to the material. Should we get 25 for this one? Here's a nicer one, Nat Nast. This one actually has embroidery on it. As you can see there. It's like a lady diving from a coconut tree. Got some sailboats, pretty cool. Size large, should be able to get probably 35 for this one. This was a nice find. Emporio Armani, it's made in Italy, and it's a cardigan sweater. Pretty nice. Should be able to get probably 40 for this one. And here's some more long sleeve shirts. This is a English Laundry. It's got embroidery work on the front as well as the back. It's got a nice dragon on the back. Size medium. It does have French cuffs, so that's a plus. Probably should get about 25 for this one. And we have not one, but two of these ex officios Buzz Off shirts. I think now they call it Bug Away for their 2013 line, but it's basically it's got like an insect shield to it, or repellent. Nice shirt. These go about $90, I think. on their website. So should be able to get probably $40 for each one. And here's the second one. Both are the same size.
Spanish, I think he speaks German because he studied in Germany and now under 80 to participate in that conflict.
Here's some shirts that you may not have on your list, but you'll probably want to keep an eye out for them. This one is Radio Shack sponsored Lance Armstrong t-shirt. And he obviously doesn't have any sponsors anymore, so this is probably the end of the line for any of these products. And should be able to get paid $1.99, should be able to get 20 for that. Here's a Filson shirt. You would want to keep an eye out for this brand. Actually, I had three of these. I sold two of them like within hours of listing for like 25 apiece. This is the last one left. I'm going to probably post it for 30. You should be able to get that. If you find the luggage from this company, you can really make some good money. Also, the jackets. They're, I think, out of Oregon. And they're made in the U.S., so good stuff. There's another odd brand, Pataloha, which is owned by Patagonia, which is strange. But, yeah, I guess this is our casual camp shirt line. But, yeah, these sell well. Should be able to get 30 bucks for this. So you'd want to keep an eye out for that, Pataloha. And here was a cool find. I've had this brand on my list for at least a year and a half, and this is the first one I ever found. But it's Paradise Found. These are made in Hawaii. And these shirts were made popular by the TV show Magnum P.I. So Tom Selleck wore this or these shirts in that show. They still sell them. You can get them anywhere between 50 and 100 bucks new. This is one of the more popular ones with the bird. I forget the model name, but she'll be getting 30 bucks for this. Well, that's it for the clothes. Now let's take a look at my last two finds, which are mid-century pieces. So this was a cool find. This is probably 1950s, 1960s, Swedish-made flatware. Company is called Gents. Let me see if I can get that on the camera here. And it doesn't look like it's going to focus. But it's G-E-N-S-E, Swiss-made. These are quite expensive. I paid $5 for the whole set. And the larger pieces here go anywhere between 20 and 40. And then for a single fork, it can sell up to $20. So that was a good find. I have about 50 pieces here. The average price for the forks and the teaspoons is about 10 plus shipping. So I'm probably going to sell the larger pieces, probably for about 25 to 30 a piece. And then I'll probably lot together like groups of four of the forks and do maybe 30 bucks a lot. But anyways, you're looking at about probably 300 in profit, maybe more. And not bad for $5. So anyways, keep an eye out for flatware. So let's check out my favorite find for the week. Okay, so this is my favorite find of the week. This is mid-century modern swag lamp. Really nice color green. And I paid $10 for this. And let me show you, let me turn the light off and then I'll show you what it looks like without the light on. Okay, so you can probably see the color a little bit better. Yeah, it's a beautiful green. Nice form to it. Yeah, so pay $10, looking to get $200 for it. Really nice. I'm almost tempted to keep it, but I just need to get rid of it. Stop keeping stuff. So anyways, those are my finds from yesterday. So thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time.